Hi, in this video, let's discuss about why we need to learn analysis of algorithms. To begin with, let's see what is an algorithm. An algorithm can be informally defined like this. An algorithm is a well-defined computational procedure that takes some value as input and produces some value or a single value as output. So the algorithm is going to take a set of values or a single value, and it has a finite set of instructions that will transform the input to a set of output or a single output. For example, let's take sorting. This is going to accept a sequence of n numbers as input, say a1, a2, a3, etc. up to an, and produces an output which is a permutation of the input, which is just a reordering a1 dash, a2 dash, etc. up to a1 dash, such that a1 dash is less than or equal to a2 dash, that is less than or equal to a3 dash, and so on up to an dash. Suppose if we give a sequence of input like this, 31, 41, 59, 26, 41 and 58 to a sorting algorithm, it is expected to produce 26, 31, 41, 41, 58 and 59 as output. And this is the sequence of input is called one instance of the problem. And when we come to analysis of algorithm, there are two parts. One is establishing the correctness of the algorithm. The other is estimating how much time and space is required to solve the problem. So the correctness of the algorithm is like this. We can say an algorithm is correct only if for every input the algorithm halts with the correct output. So establishing this correctness is hard if we follow this, because the algorithm has to produce the correct output and it has to terminate for all possible inputs, which is not very easy to, you know, experiment with. So we will mathematically establish the correctness of the algorithm, and how we can do that we will see when we go into the course. And the other aspect of the problem is estimating the efficiency of the algorithm in terms of time and memory. Suppose if we are given a computer which is infinitely fast and the computer memory is free. The question is, are we still interested to learn the analysis of algorithms? The answer is obvious, it is yes, because we have to still demonstrate the correctness of the algorithm. Even otherwise, practically if you see, the computers are fast but not infinitely fast, and the computer memory may be inexpensive but not free. So anyway, we have to do the analysis of algorithms. This is one case. The other case is like when you have more than one solution for the same problem, okay, we might be interested to know which solution to choose, which is best. If the computer memory is free and the computers are infinitely fast, then we are not worried about which is the best solution, because we can take any solution that is correct. Okay, but since it is not practical, okay, we are worried about executing a solution which is very fast. So how we can do this? So we have to find an appropriate measure to estimate this efficiency. Can we have absolute time to execute a solution as a measure of efficiency? I have an instruction that will take the system clock time before the beginning of the solution, and then I will execute the actual solution, and at the end of the solution again I will pick up the system clock time. I can find the absolute difference between the end time and the start time. And can we use this absolute time required to execute this solution as a measure of efficiency of the solution? Okay, certainly not, because it depends on the environment I use to execute this solution. Maybe my system is very sophisticated. If I run the same solution on a different computer, which is not very sophisticated, then the solution might take little longer time. So certainly the absolute time might not be a right measure. So can we use the number of lines written by the programmer as a measure of efficiency? Let's take a problem. I just wanted to print hi 10 times. This is the problem. And let's take two different programmers. One is a beginner, the other is an expert. So let's take he is writing a program in C language. So the beginner will have 10 printf statements apart from the necessary ones, which is the include statement, header file include statement, the void main function, and then the begin and end. Okay, so four statements which will be common for the beginner as well as the expert programmer. And the beginner is going to write 10 printf statements to print hi. So he is having 14 statements in his program, and the expert will use a for loop. So apart from the four necessary statements, he will have one for loop statement and a printf statement, so six statements. So can this be a good measure? So suppose if I increase the number of print statements from 10 to 100, the beginner is going to have 104 statements now, and the expert is just going to change the termination condition in the for loop, and still he is going to have only six statements in his program. So will this be a good measure? Okay, certainly not. Why? Because it depends on the capacity of the programmer, and this is not a good measure since it depends on the programmer's capacity. So we need to have some measure which is independent of the hardware or the software or the programmer that we are using to solve the problem. So we can use the number of instructions to be executed in a program to solve the problem as a measure. Okay, so let's take an example here, which is sorting again. We'll consider two solutions of the sorting. One is the insertion sort and the other is the merge sort. The insertion sort is going to take C1 n squared time to sort n number of items. And C1 is a constant which is independent of the number of items that we are sorting. And merge sort is going to take C2 n log n time. And here this log n is actually log n to the base 2. And here, how we have arrived at C1 n squared or C2 n log n, we do not know. Okay, this we are going to learn when we go into the details of analysis of algorithms. But for time being, let's assume like this. The number of instructions executed for insertion sort is C1 n squared time, and number of instructions executed for merge sort is C2 n log n. Typically, C1 is less than C2 in real time. So suppose if we write this C1 n squared as C1 n into n. N squared we have just split as n into n, and C2 n log n, and cancel this portion C1 n in insertion sort and C2 n in merge sort. What is remaining is n and log n. N for insertion sort and log n for merge sort. And when n is equal to 1000, log n is going to be approximately 10. And when n is 1 million, log n is going to be only 20. That means that the insertion sort is going to take much more time. It needs much more number of instruction to execute the same number of numbers to sort compared to the insertion sort, which is just going to take log n time. So we know that the insertion sort is a relatively slower algorithm compared to the merge sort. We'll see this using an example. will use a computer, faster computer A, to run the slower algorithm, which is the insertion sort, and we are going to use a slower machine B to run merge sort, which is a faster algorithm. Both the machines are going to solve the problem of 10 million number of inputs. And the speed of computer A is 10 billion instructions per second, and the speed of computer B is only 10 million instructions per second. That means that A is 1000 times faster than B. And to add on to this, we will assume that insertion sort is written by an expert programmer, and therefore the constant C1 is only 2, and the program written by the merge sort algorithm has resulted in a constant which is 50. So the time taken by computer A to sort 10 million numbers is like this, okay, C1 into n squared, n is 10 million, so squared, divided by the speed of A, which is 10 billion instructions per second, so which is approximately 20,000 seconds, which is more than 5.5 hours. If you consider the time taken by the merge sort by computer B, we have 50, which is C2, 10 million numbers to sort, which is n, and log n, n log n, C2, n, this is log n, divided by the speed of the machine B, which is only 10 million instructions per second, which is approximately equal to 1163 seconds, which is less than 20 minutes. So if you consider the same machines running the two different algorithms, but the size of the input is now, instead of 10 million numbers, if we increase 100 million numbers, then the insertion sort is going to take 23 days, whereas the merge sort is going to just take only 4 hours, less than 4 hours. So although the computer A is faster, okay, it depends the speed, okay, or the amount of time required to solve the problem depends on the number of instructions to be executed. So we can observe that the machine B is almost 17 times faster than A. So the analysis of algorithm is all about dealing with counting the number of instructions required to solve the problem, number of instructions that are required to solve the problem, which is executed actually by the system, not the absolute time or the number of instructions written by the programmer. So I think this gives us a clear picture of why we need to learn the analysis of algorithm. Even though we are given sophisticated machines, the faster algorithm really matters. So let's get started into the actual topic of analysis in the next video. Thank you.